Hi everyone, welcome back once again. Thanks for joining me today. Hola mis amores, gracias por estar aquí. As you can see in the title of this video, it is my May favorites, and I'm gonna jump right to it because there are quite a few products I'd like to talk about, and so I don't want to make this video too long. Most of the products I'm going to be talking to you about today is more of the cosmetics slash makeup. I don't have many I would say hair products, the facial products. I do have one of each when it comes down to the skin and the hair, so I'm gonna get started with that. First thing is the Fakai Marine Summer Hair. I've featured this on a previous favorite videos. What it does, it protects your hair from UV rays. I use this more when I go to like the beach or I'm gonna be in the pool area, just because you need to protect your hair the same way you protect your skin. So this is what I've been using, and I've always used this since last summer, and I'm loving it. I really feel it does protect my hair. The other product I want to talk to you guys about is this L'Oreal Youth Code Serum Intense. Now this serum you see here, I bought at Walgreens, and they don't have a full size. This I bought as a trial size, and it's a limited edition. They have it like on the limited edition area, like in the middle of the Walgreens, and I really, really am liking the result. What it said on the little brochure or little stand it is on, like an intensive hydrating serum where it illuminates your skin and intensively hydrates your skin, and of course that's what I'm always looking for. So it's called Youth Code. There, that's the name of it. And like I said, it is a trial size. I don't think they have this full size yet. I think this is more of a limited edition type of trial. But I just want to mention it because I really, really like it, and I'm using it every day. You use it under your moisturizer or night cream, AM or PM. Obviously in the AM it's your moisturizer, in the PM is your night cream. So I'm really, really loving this. The next products I'm going to talk to you guys about, for some reason, lately I've been obsessing with the Sigma brushes, the Kabuki brushes. For whatever reason, I had left them on the side. I started using my Real Technique brushes, and then I'm like, okay, this is not the only brushes I have, so I need to start using my other brushes. So I decided to, I was applying my foundation and my concealer, and you know, I started buffing my foundation with the flat top here, and I'm like, man, I really like how this looks. So I'm like buffing, and I'm like loving it. These brushes work so beautifully, like beautifully, beautifully. I feel like these, I guess the fibers, the bristles, I don't know, but they work really, really nice. So I usually just buff my foundation. I apply my foundation and then I just buff it in circular motions. I buff it with this one, the flat top. And then guys, this one here, the round Kabuki, the F82, I'm sorry, this one was the F80, and this is the F82. For example, you put on your concealer, all I do is kind of dab. It blends it so beautifully. Your foundation stays put, like your foundation stays exactly where you want it. I've been using these every single day that I use foundation. This is the one I use for my foundation. This is the one I use for my concealer. This one I've been using for highlight, and I'm gonna show you like how I've been using it in just a second. And this one, as you can see, I use it today. I've been using it to contour and also apply my blush. If you ever want to invest in a set of face brushes, seriously, seriously, I totally 100% with all my heart, eyes closed, hands down, guys, I have tons of brushes. If you've been following me for a while, you know I have tons of brushes. These brushes are the face brushes to have. So, I mean, no doubt in my mind. The Real Techniques brushes, I will be doing a review soon on them. I like them, but I had different expectations on them. I thought they were going to be like they were going to leave me in wow. I have used them and they are good. I'm not saying they're not, but I feel that I expected more from them. But these, quality wise, I've washed them, I spot cleaned them. I'm always washing my brushes, especially because they're my face brushes. You should always, always wash your face brushes. You know, I mean, I'm not saying every single time you use them, but you shouldn't leave them without washing for too long. If you are interested in these set of brushes, I will link the website where you can get them at on the bottom bar, just in case you want to check them out. Now, moving on to face products. The two products are NYC Sun and Bronze Powders. And in this particular case, I'm talking about the 707. The 707, which is this one here. And it's so pretty. And then the other one is 706. And it's this one. Now, as you can see, one is lighter than the other. But if I want to get like a darker, more of a bronzier look, I'll use this one. And then I'll just apply this like as blush, lightly. I actually have this one on today as bronzer and my contouring and my blush. So I use this for both. But like I said, if I want more of a warmer, darker look, I usually go for this one. As you see, I have been using it, but this is the one I have on today. But these two I am loving. They give just the perfect amount of pigmentation. They're light. You can build the intensity. So I'm really, really enjoying these two. Now these I've had, and I'm finding myself going to them all the time. Now the next product I also want to talk to you guys about is also a face product. So we are in the summertime. I hope most of you are in a state that is already warm. I know I've heard the news and a few states have been having some cold, chilly weather. Well, I'm in Florida, and in Florida it is pathetically hot already. It's like 90s. As you all know, as summer approaches, you know, the glowing skin, the dewy look, the highlighted look is really it. I went to Sally's, of course, and I was walking around the makeup area, and I'm looking. So I'm like reading, and it says, get radiant complexion enhancer. Get a radiant all over dewy glow that brightens and revives your dull complexion. Your skin will look instantly refreshed and rested. So because I'm pregnant and I'm further into my due date, I'm starting to feel super uncomfortable. I'm losing so much sleep because I'm constantly getting up to either go to the bathroom or turning around and trying to get comfy because it is almost impossible to get comfy. So I'm losing a lot of sleep. And so I could tell in the mornings when I look at myself and I'm like, I see such dark circles. I see bags under my eyes. My face looks dull. I'm like, oh. But I mean, I can't help it. So, but what I can do is use stuff like this. Yeah, I've been using this on its own. I usually don't use it like that. I usually just put it like in this area here, my illuminating area, if I'm gonna put it with my makeup. Now, you can use under or over your makeup. I personally use it after I do my foundation and my powder. It is a liquid form. I'm gonna swatch it for you. I still put it on top of my powder when I'm done, like around this area here. I actually have it on today as well with another product that I'll be showing you in just a second. Look how pretty it makes your skin look. Like, look at the difference. You see? Like, this is more of like flat, and this one is just, look how dewy, and it's beautiful. I love it. I am so in love with it. Guys, check it out. They had two different colors. This one is pearl. This one's pearl. They had like a more of a, I think it was like a pinkier color. But I thought for me, for my complexion, this would be best. And again, this is the color pearl, and the other one, I'm not sure what it's called. This is from Sally's and it's called Femme Couture, and this is what it's called. Loving this. Moving on with eyes, I have here two totally different lines. The first one is L'Oreal, and it's the infillables. This is what I have on today on my eyes and my face. And the colors are the Ice Latte, very shimmery. The other is the Endless Pearl, kind of like a matte color, more of a matte. And the other is Bottomless Java, which is like a really bronzy brown. So I have been loving these lately, and I've been loving these, however, on top of the color tattoos from Maybelline. These were L'Oreal's. These are from Maybelline. I have everything I'm showing you right now when it comes down to eyes is what I have on. These three colors that I'm showing you here is what I have on my eyes today. I have applied this, the color tattoo and the color Too Cool, which is number 5, which is like a whitey, a white color. I have that as like my base all over my eyelid. And then I applied these 3 on top of that color. Okay, here's the reason why I'm so in love with these. These are 24-hour cream shadows, okay? So these are, the Maybelline are all 24-hour cream shadows. Now the L'Oreal's are also, as you can see here, also 24-hour shadows. So I'm applying 24-hour cream shadow as my base, and then I'm applying 24-hour shadow on my eyes. That will last forever. Seriously, it lasts forever. Like when I wash my face to remove my makeup, like I really have to make sure that I get the spot. If you go to the beach and you just don't want to go plain Jane, you know, you want to have some kind of, you know, something on your eyes or your face, I totally recommend these together. Loving them. Now on the infillible, not only do I feel this stuff is amazing on my eyes, I have been using this as my highlight, which I have on today. Now, keep in mind, today I have the Get Radiant before that, and then I use this brush here, my Tapered Kabuki, which is kind of like thick here and then thinner here, and I'll use it with the very end and just use it as a highlight, and I love it. Love it. I've been getting so many compliments on my makeup lately, especially because, again, I'm into the dewy, glowy look, and this is what I've been using on my face along with this. I've been using this so much, especially because this is 24 hours, so, and I'm putting it on top of this, which is creamy, which is, you know, kind of liquid, and then I'm using that to like kind of set it. Loving it. Now on the infillables, those were those colors. The colors I've been loving on the color tattoos have been the 05, which is the one I just showed you, which was the white one, which is the Too Cool Shimmer, which is the white. And then I've also been loving the 55, which is Inked in Pink, which is this one here. Very pretty color as well. And that's the 55. And then the other color that I've loved since day one has been the Tough as Taupe, which is the number 35. And this color I usually use just to kind of sort of contour my eye when I'm using these colors, you know, to go out. But yeah, those 3 have been my favorite colors for the color tattoos from Maybelline. And then these 3 colors have been my favorite for the infillible, for the L'Oreal infillible shadows. And again, I've actually have been using them to highlight, like especially the infillible ice latte one. Guys, this is so beautiful. It works so beautifully. It gives such a beautiful reflection. Anyway, so moving on, I've always raved with this, but this stuff is like, seriously, I went back to it. Covers beautifully, it stays on, and it doesn't move like other concealers. Like the Prolong Wear, I really enjoy. It's just the consistency, it's just not as thick as this one. So if you want like a more of a full coverage, more of a thicker consistency, seriously guys, go with this. Like especially if you have like really dark circles under your eyes and bags under your eyes, this is the stuff. Like I'm really, really liking this. Like I've been using this every single day whenever I use concealer. It's heavy duty concealer, and it really, really stays on. Now moving on is lips. As you guys know, orange is going to be the color of the moment. I was at Ulta and this girl, oh my God, what color do you have on your lips? It was like so bright, and in your face, it was so pretty. It was beautiful. And she was really, like, I would say fair skin. So I was like, my God, if it looks like that on her, imagine on a darker skin tone. So I was like, oh my gosh, I had to ask her. I was like, oh my gosh, you know, if you don't mind me asking, what color do you have on your lips? And she's like, oh, it's from NYX, one of the matte NYX color lipsticks. And she told me it's called Indie Flick. And I'm like, did you get it here? She's like, yeah, I got it here. She's like, I got it here last week. And I'm like, oh my God, I'm gonna go check it out. Well, I went to go check it out and it was the last one. And guys, this color is so pretty. It is so pretty. It's like an orange. It might look red on camera, but it is so orange. It's like a really deep orange. It's like an orange, and I am loving it. So I have a tutorial coming up. I'm actually editing where I'm using this lipstick, and it's so beautiful. So yeah, I'm loving this orange here. And I like to combine it with this L'Oreal's Le Gloss, and it's Peach Fuzz. And actually, I have on my lips, guys, you would not believe what I have on my lips today. I have this Peach Fuzz with an orange pigment that I mix these two together, and that's what I have on my lips. And I actually mixed a little bit of the other favorite of mine for this month, OCC's Lip Tarte in the color Ice. So I actually have these three things together. This is not one of my favorites. I mean, pigments, MAC, of course, anybody favorite, anytime, but it's not part of the video. But I just wanted to mention, in case you guys wanted to know, I have this lip gloss here mixed with this orange pigment, and then I applied a little bit of the Iced Lip Tarte for OCC, which is a favorite of mine for this month as well, on my lips today. So yeah, so it's for the lips is the NYX matte lipstick, the Peach Fuzz 158 from L'Oreal, this here. And I usually, when I wear this, I usually wear a little bit of this because this is kind of matte and I don't like my lips to look too matte because it kind of chaps my lips too and I don't like that. And of course, OCC Lip Tars. These things are so amazing, like so amazing. In particular, these are the two colors I've been going to a lot, which is the Kava Kava, which is this one, and then this one is the Ice. This one I don't use it alone because it's like really white, but I mix it a lot with other colors. So it's like I mostly use it on matte colors so it could give it that just a little of that gloss shimmer. But yeah, these two. And the other lip product is the Milani Hot Flash Full Coverage Lip Gloss. Guys, this stuff is so good. I think I mentioned this before on another favorites as well, but this stuff is so amazing. Like, it'll stay on all day. And the color is very pretty as well. So if I'm in the pink mood, this is what I go for. And it's so pigmented and it's thick, but it's not like that. I don't know if you ever used like a lip gloss that's kind of sticky, that is actually, it bothers you. It's so pretty. And I really, really like it. And it stays on, guys. That's the most important thing. It stays on. Last but not least, guys, the Milani Infinite Waterproof Eyeliner. Again, we're in the summertime. This stuff is waterproof. This stuff actually, in order to get this stuff off your eyes, you gotta work on those eyes. You really, really. I love it because it's really black. It's easy to use. It's somewhat of a thick consistency, as you can see. I don't know if you can see the brush. It's a thick consistency, but it's really black and it works beautifully. It works nicely, so I really, really like it. And again, when I know I'm going to be out in the sun, when I know I'm going to be hot and sticky and sweaty, this is the eyeliner I go for. So yeah, guys, that's pretty much it for my May favorites. I hope that you guys enjoyed the video as always. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments area.